Uranium-238 is the most common isotope of uranium found in nature. It is not fissile, but is a fertile material. It can capture a slow neutron and after two beta decays become fissile plutonium-239. 238U is fissionable by fast neutrons, but cannot support a chain reaction because inelastic scattering reduces neutron energy below the range where fast fission of one or more next-generation nuclei is probable. Doppler broadening of U-238's neutron absorption resonances, increasing absorption as fuel temperature increases, is also an essential negative feedback mechanism for reactor control. Around 99.284% of natural uranium is uranium-238, which has a half-life of 1.41 times 10 17 seconds. Depleted uranium has an even higher concentration of the 238U isotope, and even low-enriched uranium, while having a higher proportion of the uranium-235 isotope, is still mostly 238U. Reprocessed uranium is also mainly 238U, with about as much uranium-235 as natural uranium, a comparable proportion of uranium-236, and much smaller amounts of other isotopes of uranium such as uranium-234, uranium-233, and uranium-232. Nuclear energy applications. In a fission nuclear reactor, uranium-238 can be used to breed 239 Pu, which itself can be used in a nuclear weapon or as a nuclear reactor fuel supply. In a typical nuclear reactor, up to one-third of the generated power does come from the fission of 239 Pu, which is not supplied as a fuel to the reactor, but rather, produced from 238 U. Breeder reactors 238U is not usable directly as nuclear fuel, though it can produce energy via fast fission. In this process, a neutron that has a kinetic energy in excess of 1 MeV can cause the nucleus of 238U to split in two. Depending on design, this process can contribute some 1 to 10% of all fission reactions in a reactor, but too few of the about 1.7 neutrons produced in each fission have enough speed to continue a chain reaction. 238U can be used as a source material for creating plutonium-239, which can in turn be used as nuclear fuel. Breeder reactors carry out such a process of transmutation to convert the fertile isotope 238U into fissile Pu-239. It has been estimated that there is anywhere from 10,000 to 5 billion years worth of 238U for use in these power plants. Breeder technology has been used in several experimental nuclear reactors. By December 2005, the only breeder reactor producing power was the 600-megawatt BN-600 reactor at the Beloyarsk nuclear power station in Russia. Russia has planned to build another unit, BN-800, at the Beloyarsk nuclear power plant. Also, Japan's Monju breeder reactor is planned to be started, having been shut down since 1995, and both China and India have announced plans to build nuclear breeder reactors. The breeder reactor, as its name implies, creates even larger quantities of Pu-239 than the fission nuclear reactor. The clean and environmentally safe advanced reactor, a nuclear reactor concept that would use steam as a moderator to control delayed neutrons, will potentially be able to burn 238U as fuel once the reactor is started with LEU fuel. This design is still in the early stages of development. Radiation shielding 238U is also used as a radiation shield. Its alpha radiation is easily stopped by the non-radioactive casing of the shielding, and the uranium's high atomic weight and high number of electrons are highly effective in absorbing gamma rays and X-rays. It is not as effective as ordinary water for stopping fast neutrons. Both metallic depleted uranium and depleted uranium dioxide are used for radiation shielding. Uranium is about 5 times better as a gamma ray shield than lead, so a shield with the same effectiveness can be packed into a thinner layer. DuCrete, a concrete made with uranium dioxide aggregate instead of gravel, is being investigated as a material for dry cask storage systems to store radioactive waste. Downblending, the opposite of enriching, is downblending. Surplus highly enriched uranium can be downblended with depleted uranium or natural uranium to turn it into low enriched uranium suitable for use in commercial nuclear fuel. 238 U from depleted uranium and natural uranium is also used with recycled Pu-239 from nuclear weapons stockpiles for making mixed oxide fuel, which is now being redirected to become fuel for nuclear reactors. This dilution, also called downblending, means that any nation or group that acquired the finished fuel would have to repeat the very expensive and complex chemical separation of uranium in plutonium process before assembling a weapon. Nuclear weapons. Most modern nuclear weapons utilize 238 U as a tamper material. A tamper which surrounds a fissile core works to reflect neutrons and to add inertia to the compression of the Pu-239 charge. As such, it increases the efficiency of the weapon and reduces the critical mass required. In the case of a thermonuclear weapon, 238 U can be used to encase the fusion fuel. The high flux of very energetic neutrons from the resulting fusion reaction causes 238 U nuclei to split and adds more energy to the yield of the weapon. Such weapons are referred to as fission-fusion fission weapons after the 3 consecutive stages of the explosion. An example of such a weapon is Castle Bravo. The larger portion of the total explosive yield in this design comes from the final fission stage fueled by 238 U, producing enormous amounts of radioactive fission products. For example, an estimated 77% of the 10.4-megaton yield of the Ivy Mike thermonuclear test in 1952 came from fast fission of the depleted uranium tamper. Because depleted uranium has no critical mass, it can be added to thermonuclear bombs in almost unlimited quantity. The Soviet Union's test of the Tsar bomber in 1961 produced only 60 megatons of explosive power, over 90% of which came from fusion. Because the 238 U final stage had been replaced with lead, had 238 U been used instead, the yield of the Tsar bomber could have been well above 100 megatons, and it would have produced nuclear fallout equivalent to 1/3 of the global total that had been produced up to that time. Radioactivity and decay. 238 U radiates alpha particles and decays into uranium-234. 234 U has a half-life of 245,500 years. The relation between 238 U and 234 U gives an indication of the age of sediments that are between 100,000 years and 1,200,000 years in age. The Voyager spacecrafts carry small amounts of initially pure 238 U on the covers of their golden records to facilitate dating in the same manner. 238 U occasionally decays by spontaneous fission or double beta decay with probabilities of 5 × 10⁻⁷ and 2 × 10⁻½ per alpha decay, respectively. Radium series. The 4N+2 chain of 238 U is commonly called the radium series. Beginning with naturally occurring uranium-238, this series includes the following elements: astatine, bismuth, lead, polonium, protactinium, radium, radon, thallium, and thorium. All are present, at least transiently, in any uranium-containing sample, whether metal, compound, or mineral. The mean lifetime of 238U is 1.41 times 10 17 seconds divided by 0.693, i.e., California, 2 times 10 17 seconds. So 1 mole of 238U emits 3 times 106 alpha particles per second, producing the same number of thorium-234 atoms. In a closed system, an equilibrium would be reached with all amounts except for Li-206 and 238U in fixed ratios. In slowly decreasing amounts, the amount of Pb-206 will increase accordingly while that of 238U decreases. All steps in the decay chain have this same rate of 3 times 106 decayed particles per second per mole 238U. Thorium-234 has a mean lifetime of 3 times 106 seconds, so there is equilibrium if 1 mole of 238U contains 9 times 10^12 atoms of thorium-234, which is 1.5 times 10 minus 11 mole. Similarly, in an equilibrium in a closed system, the amount of each decay product, except the end product lead, is proportional to its half-life. As already touched upon above, when starting with pure 238U, within a human timescale the equilibrium applies for the first 3 steps in the decay chain only. Thus, for 1 mole of 238U, 3 times 106 times per second 1 alpha and 2 beta particles and gamma ray are produced together 6.7 MeV, a rate of 3 microwatts. Extrapolated over 2 times 10 17 seconds, this is 600 gigajoules, the total energy released in the first 3 steps in the decay chain.